What's going on, y'all? Jake here with Eventer Visuals, and today I am stoked because we are going to be breaking down how I color grade different types of music videos. Color grading music videos is actually one of my favorite parts of the entire editing process, and I think it's one of the most valuable parts of the process as well. Color grading can really help take okay looking footage and take it to a whole nother level, and if you shoot good footage, color grading will make your footage look absolutely incredible. So today I'm going to be showing you guys how to color grade within Premiere Pro. A lot of people like to debate whether or not Premiere Pro is even worth using for color grading because of programs like DaVinci Resolve. But personally, I like having everything in-house. I don't like, you know, jumping around to other softwares just to do one thing. I like to stay within the Adobe Creative Suite, just using Premiere Pro and After Effects for 90% of the stuff that I work on. I just want to give a quick shout out to everybody who has subscribed to the channel and helped me grow this community. It's been absolutely mind-blowing to me how many people across the entire world have seen my videos and reached out to me on Instagram or on YouTube. I'm very curious about what countries you guys are watching my videos in. So if you would like to comment below, what country are you currently living in? I'm very interested in traveling to other countries, and it's been great connecting with people from all over the world. So we are here in Premiere Pro, and I've got a timeline set up here. It's a pretty basic timeline. I've got three different music videos here. We have this recent one that I edited in my last tutorial a little bit, my data moshing tutorial. And then we have this one where there's some indoor lighting. And then we have this one over here where most of the shots were just outside. It's the same scene over and over again for this music video. Some modern cameras you can shoot in this mode called log, and it's basically going to flatten out your image more. It's going to make all of your colors more neutral, and it's going to give you more freedom to color grade in Adobe Premiere Pro or any other video editing software. So if you have a more modern camera, there's a good chance that you can tweak your settings and set it to record in a log format so that you have more ability to color grade your videos later on. And it'll also shoot at a higher dynamic range, which means the sky won't look completely blown out, the shadows won't look too dark. So you want to have a really balanced dynamic range so that, you know, when it comes down to coloring your footage, it's way, way easier and way more customizable. So that being said, these first two examples are shot in log. You can see how flat these images are. You can just tell right away that there's barely any saturation, not a lot of contrast. And that's basically what shooting log means. It's going to give you a really flat image versus this footage here on the end. This is probably just a automatic color profile shot on a DSLR, probably a slightly older camera model here. So with this first clip here, you can basically tell that all of these scenes are the same. They're all shot outside on this driveway at about the same time of day. So you can really just color grade one of these clips and just apply that same grade to the rest of these clips without having to do much tweaking. What you can do is come down here to the bottom left, new item, and select an adjustment layer. So we can create an adjustment layer, hit OK. That's going to make an adjustment layer here in our project panel. I'm just going to slide that above our footage layer right here and just drag it out so it lasts the entire duration. Switch from my workspace in editing and switch it over to the color workspace. And then you can see we got the Lumetri sliders over here on the right. White balance is just going to be how accurate the whites are in this image. For example, does this white car look like a natural white color, or is it too warm? Is it too cool? You can automatically set the white balance using the temperature, the tint, and the saturation. But for this image, the white balance looks pretty dang good already. Now, if I were to switch to this last clip that we're going to edit here, you can see that the whites in this image are very, very warm. We need to fix that a little bit later, but for now we're just gonna focus on this music video right here. And so what I'm gonna do at this point, just pretty much ignore the white balance for now, and I'm just gonna bump up the contrast. I like to take the contrast up pretty high. Let's go to like 45 there. What I like to do to flatten out this image even more and to make it even a little bit more cinematic is to drop the highlights down to say 30. Let's bring the shadows up to 20, increase the whites since there's a lot of like bright white color. And then I'm gonna take the blacks down a hair as well. And if I take the blacks to the extreme, you can see it's only changing the very black parts of the image. So this can be used to add even more contrast, but that's basically all I do here. Sometimes if the shot's a little bit dark, I'll bump up the exposure just a hair, but I usually try not to mess around with this exposure too much because we can alter kind of the overall exposure using the curves and some other settings as well. Because this clip right here was shot outside on what looks like more of a wintry day, you can tell like the leaves aren't on the trees and there's, you know, it just looks cold. He's wearing a hoodie and everything. What I'm gonna do is emphasize kind of like the cooler colors by just taking our white balance temperature and dragging it to the left a little bit until I'm comfortable. So let's close out of these menus. Let's hop into creative. And what I like to do is just to increase my sharpen a little bit. I usually bring this up to like 10. And then I like to take the vibrance down just a hair and maybe the saturation down as well, just a little bit. And that's just gonna make our image look even a little bit more flat. So then I'm just gonna close my adjustments right here and open up my curves. For this curve in particular, what I like to do in pretty much every single music video, and this is what I was talking about before with the exposure. So I like to just take the curve up a little bit, and you can see that that makes our image brighter there, but I don't want to do it too much, just a little bit on each end of this. Is create a point. I'm going to drag it down here. That's going to give us a little bit more contrast. I'm also going to take kind of the highlights down just a little bit. Now you can play around with like the red. So for example, if you move the reds up, you can really make your image a little bit warmer, or we can go a little bit more green and cool tones right there. Just like with the white curve, you can create separate points on this tone curve, on each of these tone curves if you want. You know, let's actually bring a little bit more warmth back up in there. Maybe I'll bring the greens down just a little bit and give us more of that like reddish color right there. I can spend hours tweaking the curves, playing around with different looks, and that's why LUTs are really popular with video editors, because it saves you a lot of time because you can just scroll through them. A little bit farther down, we have hue versus saturation, hue versus hue, hue versus luma, and luma versus saturation. And then we also have saturation versus saturation. So what I like to do is just start with this luma versus saturation. And this is just basically where we're gonna clean up our shadows and our highlights a little bit. So highlights are gonna be these blown out areas, and then shadows are gonna be these, you know, shadowy areas. With the highlights and the shadows, you don't want those to have a lot of saturation. And this is just gonna give us a cleaner look overall. So what I'm gonna do is just create a point here on this line, and then I'm gonna create a point over here, and then I'm gonna create another point. I'm gonna drag that down at the end, at either end. I'm just gonna make a point like that, and that's gonna make sure that our highlights and our shadows stay desaturated. So they're either gonna be white or black. There's not gonna be a whole lot of color in those areas, and that's just gonna sharpen up our image even more and make it look even more crispy. Up here, you got a bunch of different options. This one is actually one of my favorites right here, hue versus saturation. I think this is why they put it at the top, because it's probably the most powerful way to go about doing this next effect. So one thing I noticed in this music video is his red hoodie really stands out to me versus like the background. It really pops out. So I kind of want to emphasize his red hoodie a little bit more. So what I'm going to do is just create 3 points in the red section of this hue and saturation. And what this is gonna do is it's gonna tell Premiere Pro that in these hues, in these colors, do we wanna desaturate these colors or do we wanna saturate these colors? So I'm actually gonna bump the red hoodie up and we're gonna saturate it way more so it really pops out. So I can drag this knob up here and you can see how much more saturated his hoodie gets in this picture. Now I could, you know, desaturate it entirely and make it look more black and white. So I'm just gonna bump it up pretty extensively right there. And then as I scroll over here a little bit more, let's find another shot here so we can make sure this isn't looking weird on any of these other shots, which as you can see, this is starting to look pretty good on these other shots too. And that's just because it's the scene is very similar in each shot. You know, hue versus hue, what we can do is change the colors. If we wanna do the same thing with our red, if we wanna change his red hoodie to another color, we can do that. We can just select the reds and give his, you know, hoodie an entirely new color if we want to, while the rest of the shot remains the same. So you wanna make sure that you have these three dots, you know, cause the two on the end are gonna keep it from impacting the rest of these colors, while this one in the middle is gonna be what you use to tweak the individual colors. So, you know, we can tweak his outfit, make it look a little more pink, whatever. It's up to you. For this, I'm just gonna leave it. And then this one, hue versus luma, is basically how bright or how dark you want these colors to be. So we can, you know, decrease the brightness of the reds by doing this, pulling his reds down right there. Obviously that looks terrible. Or we could bump it up a lot. That looks terrible as well. So ultimately, I'm not gonna do much. I'm not gonna do much with this. Don't need to. You know, this shot is already really clean. You know, it doesn't take a lot of tweaking to get it sitting right. So now at this point in the process, what I like to do is just turn the Lumetri color off and on so we can see the before and after. So there's the before and there's the after so far. And now what I'm gonna do is come to color wheels and match. This is where you can do a little bit more of fine tweaking. Let's go ahead and make the highlights. Let's go ahead and make those a little bit more blue. So let's just drag the highlights to this, you know, a little bit more down in the blue there. And then let's take the shadows and make the shadows a little bit more warm. So you can see how the image is starting to change around a little bit. I think we're just gonna go cooler on the midtones as well. And then I'm gonna come back up here to basic correction under color, and we're gonna take the temperature back and just make it a little bit warmer. So let's go to like -7.5. Now HLS secondary, this is, you know, personal preference. I'm not a huge fan of using HSL secondary. It's just because it just doesn't look good. In my opinion, I just hate the functionality of this part of the Lumetri color. But just for the sake of this tutorial, we can go over it real quick. So if I hit this plus dropper, I can hit plus on his hoodie right here, on the color of his hoodie, and then we can change, you know, this, it's basically doing the same thing that we did with the curves up a little bit higher, where we did the hue versus saturation. It's just, I don't know, it's just this way just feels a little uglier to me, and it's basically doing the same thing that you can do in the hue saturation curves. It's personal preference. I personally don't like using HSL secondary. I'm not a fan of it. So I'm just gonna reset that for now. We're just gonna ignore it, and I'm just gonna come down here a little bit farther to where it says vignette. I'm gonna click on vignette, and I am gonna take the vignette. I'm gonna go a little bit in the negatives. Now you can see it starts creeping in on the sides here. And now this is personal preference too, but I really like to put vignettes on my music videos. I think it helps bring some of the detail around the edges back in a little bit. We can increase the feather, decrease the feather. You can see now it's a little bit easier to see this vignette around the edges. But for now, I'm just gonna leave the feather where it's at. More vignette, probably the more dramatic looking. So now as I scroll back here, you can see that, you know, this part of the image up here where the vignette is darker from the rest of this image. So if I bump my vignette back up, I can even go to the maximum to the right here, and that's gonna give us a white vignette, which I'm not really a fan of. I never really used the white vignettes for anything. I've only ever used like the darker vignettes, but this looks good. I think I'm gonna just leave it around -1.5. It's looking pretty good right here. So let's go ahead and check out what this clip looks like before and after. So here's before. Right there, you can see it's just very warm, very flat, very beige here in the background. And then this is with our color grade. Boom, so it's a lot cooler. His hoodie pops more. The sky looks a lot better. It's a little bit sharper. But I do wanna cover these next two examples as well, because they're slightly different clips than the first example. So for this one, I wanted to show you guys, you know, some of these indoor clips and how we would color grade some of these. So let's grade this shot right here where he's sitting in the chair and he's inside. We had a couple lights set up in this room just to kind of give it a vibe. So you get these purple and orange kind of tones, these purple and yellow kind of tones in the actual video shot. The process is basically the same though. I'm gonna start with my basic correction. I'm gonna open up my color and my light. I'm gonna bring the exposure up just a hair, bring the contrast up a bunch. I'm using log footage here. If you're not shooting log, I would leave your contrast lower because your camera is already gonna apply a good amount of contrast. And now what I'm gonna do is actually bump up the highlights a little bit. So I think that'll help with the overall brightness of the image. Even bump up the shadows just a hair. Let's take up the whites as well and take the blacks down. Let's go to like -5. I'm gonna increase the sharpen. Let's go to 10. Let's decrease the vibrance by 5. Let's decrease the saturation. And now I'm gonna open up my curves. Let's do RGB curves, bump up the mids here on the whites. Make sure that we keep some contrast there at the bottom, bring it back here at the top as well. And now I'm gonna go to the hue and saturation curves. I'm actually gonna use the eyedropper tool for this. I'm gonna click on the color of his skin, and that's gonna create 3 points here automatically. So I actually wanna desaturate his skin a little bit. We can actually take the saturation color down. That's giving us a more natural skin color look right there, right? That looks a little more natural than say if I went the other way. You know, he looks like he's on fire or something. So we need to bring this to where his skin is gonna look natural to our eye. Now, one thing you gotta keep in mind is if you're using like a PC, you wanna make sure that you have a color accurate monitor so that, you know, when you're editing and when you're posting, it's not gonna look like two entirely different color grades. It's just looking a little bit more washed out than I like to. So I might even bring up some more of that saturation, maybe in like the mid range. So for this luma and saturation right here, let's actually bring up some more saturation in the mids. And then let's take the highlights and the shadows down. And this is something I do in like every single clip. I always take the highlight saturation and the shadow saturation down to pretty much zero. Then we have saturation versus saturation. Not really gonna touch that too much. I think maybe like the lower the saturation, we'll bump up these lows a little bit. You see how that's working on the left side of our screen there, or we can go all the way down, make it flat. Now that's starting to look a little bit cool too. Maybe we'll do the same thing on this one. come up with like two lines here, bump these curves down. I'm not a huge fan of this, so I'm actually just gonna uncheck this box, and that's gonna prevent us from seeing the saturation versus saturation. So now we're starting to get a little bit more of a stylized look here. If I just click on and off on this color grade, we can see the before, here's the after. It's just a slight facelift so far. Change the shadows up on our color wheels. Let's make the shadows a little warmer. Let's actually take the midtones, make the midtones a little bit cooler, bump up the highlights a little bit, bring some more exposure back into this clip here. That's looking pretty decent. And then we can come down here to vignette and apply a little vignette onto this clip as well. So we kind of emphasize the middle of this clip. Now what I'm gonna do to make this even a little bit more brighter is come back up to my curves, bump up this middle line a little bit more, give us some more brightness there in the middle. And that's starting to look, you know, semi-decent right there. Now I'm still not a huge fan of the skin tones, so I'm gonna tweak those a little bit more. That looks okay, that's looking a little bit better. Let's see what the before and after looks like for this clip, right? So there's the before, there's the after, right? So we got a completely different look, and it's actually looking pretty nice. It's looking natural. Skin tones look a little bit better. Let's go ahead and color grade some footage that isn't shot in log. This is a music video that I'm currently working on. It's just very orange, it's very yellow. You can just tell that the white balance wasn't set correctly in camera, and that's why it looks this way. Now, if you would have set the white balance to street lighting or tungsten lighting, I think is what it's called in camera, this would look a lot more natural. These lights wouldn't look so yellow. They'd look more white. So this is gonna be more of a challenge here because this is not a flat image. So let's go ahead and take a swing at this one and just see if we can bring it back to life a little bit. So the first thing I'm gonna do is try to adjust my white balance a little bit. So I'm actually gonna bring the temperature down, decrease some of that warmth a little bit, get that out of here. And then I'm gonna play with the tint a little bit as well. Again, getting rid of some of that warmth. Can also decrease the saturation a little bit. This is flattening out our image, right? And it's much better, you know, like I say, to edit a flat image than one with a bunch of color when you import it. As we can see now, if I just turn the Lumetri color off and on, we're starting to get a little bit more natural looking clip here. Let's increase some of that sharpness up to 10. It's something I do with basically every clip. Decrease the vibrance again and the saturation a little bit. So really washing out the clip a lot more. And now with these curves, like I always do, just bring up those middles a little bit, and then we'll tweak the bottom, make sure we still have the contrast. I'm gonna go ahead and select kind of this beige color right here that is really prevalent in this image. And I'm actually gonna make another point right here because I think I'm gonna do a decent amount of work in this area. And we're gonna decrease the saturation of some of these yellows and these greens. So we can actually drag all the way down. Let's see what this looks like. So you can see that we're completely desaturating the color of the tree there, but this is not what we want. We want the tree to remain somewhat saturated. So we need to make sure the greens stay relatively higher, bring the yellows up back a little bit. We don't need to be too extreme with it. Let's move the orange over a little bit and boom. Now the image is looking a lot more natural. Let's do another hue right here on some of those beige curves. And here we go. We can tweak the color of all these beige. There's only so much you can do when the footage is this yellow, but it's getting there. It's getting there. So I'm just gonna ignore hue versus luma for now. Down a little farther, I'm gonna change the luma versus saturation. We're gonna desaturate the highlights and the shadows. So that just makes our image look a little more crispy. I'm gonna come to vignette. Let's take the vignette down a little bit. Let's click on our color wheels and match and just give it a slight. Let's just cool it down just slightly in the shadows, and then the highlights, we'll cool those down as well. And that's just, you know, getting rid of that beigey color that this clip had originally. So now look at this. If I turn this off, this is what the clip looked like originally. And then this is with a correction and a grade. So you can see this looks way more natural looking and normal looking for how like it looks on the street at nighttime versus this. Most cameras come with a setting in the white balance settings to counter that so that you can shoot your footage more like that. Now, if he sent me this footage, you know, in the white balance was correct and it looked more like this, where it was kind of flat and even, I could then do more stylization in the color grade itself. But because this clip had so much orange, so many yellow and beige tones, just kind of mashed in there, and there's not really a whole lot of separation with his skin color in the background, it's a lot more difficult of a task to get this looking looking better, looking good. Now I'm gonna show you guys how to save this color grade as a LUT. Go ahead and click on this little hamburger menu up by Lumetri Color, and we're gonna hit export cube. I already have a folder set up on my desktop called LUTs, and we're just gonna save this. Let's just call this orange night. And we're gonna hit save. And that's gonna save our LUT. So now when we come to another clip that's similar, like this one has a ton of orange, you know, and it's nighttime, just looks kind of weird. So what we're gonna do is apply this LUT that we created on our last clip. Open up our basic correction, and where it says input LUT, none, we can say browse, and then we can find our orange times night. So there you go, just be mindful of, you know, skin tones, be mindful of outdoor lighting, be mindful of time, what time of day you're shooting. If you're shooting outside, be mindful of the types of lights that you're using if you're shooting indoors, and make sure that you have your white balance set and your camera settings look good and nice and flat before you attempt to hit record, right? Because if you're shooting footage in camera that looks like this, where it's totally orange, it's just gonna take you longer to color correct and color grade. So save yourself some time. Shoot your footage flat, use the right white balance settings in your camera, and then bring it into Premiere Pro and apply, you know, either a LUT or do your own custom grade on it. Color grading is a very tedious and time consuming process, and this is why people love to buy LUT packs on the internet. And if you guys are interested in adding some sauce to your videos today, definitely check out my website, venturevisuals.com. Got overlays, transitions, presets, and more on there, all of which you can try for free when you download the free pack on my website, which I'll include a link to below. Please feel free to comment below any questions that you might have, and hit me up on Instagram at Venture Visuals. I'd be happy to chat with you, answer any questions you might have, or just chop it up. So let me know, guys. I appreciate you guys tuning in for another video. Till next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.